Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we are writing inequalities from a picture or representation on a number line. Let's start with something we've already tried and we know from the previous skill. Draw the following inequality on the number line. So pause the video and make sure you can do that. Now here we're saying all the numbers x that are strictly less than positive 1 and bigger than or equal to negative 2. So our circles should be at negative 2 here and should be at positive 1 here. Because we are bigger than or equal to negative 2, we're going to colour in this particular circle here. And because we are strictly less than 1, we don't colour in that one there. And we draw ourselves a line between them to represent all the x numbers between lower than positive 1 and bigger than or equal to negative 2. And we're done. Now that's the skill we did in the last video, going from the inequality to the picture, and in this particular video we're going to go from the picture back to the inequality. We're just practicing that skill. So straight away, let's give that a go. Just before I get there, I just want to point out I'm going to introduce some slightly new notation for you, so it's really important you have a look at that bit and take note, because sometimes you'll see it written differently in different textbooks or different exams, etc. Right. What inequalities are represented on each number line? Pause the video and have a go. Okay, what's this one here? They're all the numbers x, okay, and we're going to use x. You could use a, b, y, or whatever, but let's just use x. And they're the numbers to the left of positive 2, not including 2. So they are x less than, strictly less than 2. What about this one? Well, it looks almost the same apart from the circles coloured in, so it's x less than or equal to positive 2. And what about this one? It's all the numbers to the right of 2, so bigger than 2, but also equal to because it's coloured in. So this is x bigger than or equal to 2. Now, I'm going to show you two other ways of writing that sometimes you'll see it written in textbooks and in tests and etc. So it's really important you just notice these other ways. One is very like this. It's called set notation. It has these brackets like this, and it has an x there, and it has a colon, and that means the set of x. That there means set of x's, and this colon here means such that. That's basically what that means. So this is the set of x such that x less than 2. You write exactly what you did before, but you close that set off. And sometimes you will see it written like that. So the set of x such that x is less than 2. You will see that written. So it's important that you're familiar with that notation there and you're used to it. There's one other way that you sometimes see it written. I'm just going to throw this in just in case. It's x less than 2. So what you do is 2 you can write there with a comma. And because you're not including 2, you write a curly brackets there, and you would go all the way to the end of the number line, which we denote as negative infinity. Okay, and you can't ever reach negative infinity, so you put a curly bracket there as well. So that's kind of university late level, but you may see that, so I'm just showing it just in case. How would you see this written in the set of x such that? You would have a bracket. It's the set of x such that x less than or equal to 2. You can see that this notation is very like this. It's very easy. How would you see it written with this here? Well, 2 and negative infinity you would still have, and you can never reach negative infinity, so you have a curly bracket, but you would have a square bracket to indicate that you can equal 2. And what about this one here? Well, this one here would be the set of x such that x is bigger than or equal to 2. And what about this bracket notation here? It's all the x's bigger than or equal to 2. So 2 is your first number. You're looking to go all the way up to infinity, which you can't reach, so you put a curly bracket. But you want to include 2, so you put a square bracket there. So I'm just showing you the different ways. That is the most popular way, to be honest with you. That is probably the second most popular way. Right, like that, and you may see that more often than not. And this last one here, you may just see sometimes, but why not point it out to you just so that you're familiar with all different ways of writing it. Okay, one last set of questions. Let's have a go at this. Pause the video, double check you can do it. Right, here we're looking for the set of x, and the key numbers are 2 and negative 5, like that. And we are strictly less than 2 and strictly bigger than negative 5 because they're not coloured in. If we want to use the set notation, we have our brackets and we say x such that, and we just copy that out, x is strictly between negative 5 and 2 like that. And if we wanted to use the bracket notation, well, I would just write the numbers between negative 5 and 2 here, and I don't want to include negative 5, so I have a curly bracket, and I don't want to include positive 2, so I have a curly bracket. It kind of looks like a set of coordinates, but sometimes you see it written like that. And what about this one here? Well, you would say x and the key numbers are 0 and negative 7. Now, x must be strictly bigger than negative 7 because that's not coloured in, but it can be less than or equal to 0. In set notation, it could be the set of x such that, and you can therefore write negative 7. X is bigger than negative 7 but less than or equal to 0. And you could write it in the other notation as negative 7 with a curly bracket all the way up to 0 with a square bracket on it like that, because 0 is included. And the last one here, it's the set of x, and 7's a key number and negative 1's a key number, and it's x less than or equal to 7 but bigger than or equal to negative 1. In set notation, we could write x, the set of x, such that negative 1 like that, or we could write it with our brackets. Now, it's between negative 1 and 7. We can put a comma between. We put a square bracket there because it can equal negative 1, and we could put a square bracket there because it could equal 7. And that's it for this video. That's all the different ways of expressing an inequality. Just be most familiar, I think, with these, and that should get you by. All right? Thanks for watching.